Good morning. This is Christy from Forever Fit, and I'm going to lead you through some morning yoga poses to kind of get you woken up, ready to start your day. There's several reasons that a morning practice is so good. For one thing, you've been curled up in maybe strange sleep poses all night, and it's a way to unwind and kind of just open up, spread out again. Another thing, it's a good time to check in and just figure out how you're feeling, if you have areas of tightness, of soreness perhaps from the rest of your week, and you can just kind of check in. And then also just to kind of breathe, you want to start opening up and unwinding, really using that breath to kind of get big and wake up all the systems of your body. So we're going to begin just sitting comfortably. Take a second and make sure that you're grounded through the low body. You just feel like this nice lift through the upper body. Just let your hands rest where they feel comfortable. And when you're ready, let your eyes drift closed. Just take a nice deep breath in and out. Check in and notice if you have any holding patterns. Maybe you're pinching between the eyebrows or clenching the jaw, maybe some carryover from when you were sleeping. So just start to soften through the face. Let go, relax. If you're wearing your shoulders up like earrings, take a second. Exhale, let them melt away. Just start deepening the breath a little bit at a time. Gently let your chin drop to your chest, and don't let the shoulders hunch forward at all. Keep yourself open, keep the collarbone spread and nice openness across the chest, and just let your chin drop. Feel a nice stretch creep up through the back of the neck, and then just start whatever feels like a nice movement for you, not forcing anything, maybe just a little rock from side to side. Feeling it today and your neck is okay with it, you can maybe go into more of a full circle, but again, really be honest and figure out what feels good and then do that. We're going to bring our chin back to our chest, and when you're ready, just slowly let your head float back up, let your eyes open. Good. We're going to send our arms out wide and take a second just to start to unwind a little bit by bringing the palms down and then up. Couple times, and then circle the wrists, wiggle the fingers, and then with your next inhale, let's fill the lungs and lift those arms up with the eyes up into the sky as well. We're going to interclasp the fingers, and then let the chin again drop to the chest as we bring the hands to the back of the head. And again, without hunching forward, just let the chin drop, let those elbows point down and the arms be heavy, and then with your next inhale, open up across the chest. Send those elbows out wide and really feel this like unwinding and opening up. And then exhale, curl it back in. And inhale, open up. And exhale. Last one, big breath. Fill the lungs. Let those lungs expand and then exhale. Curl it in. Good. Lift back up and then unwind the hands. Reach up. And then on your next exhale, let's sway to the right, let that right arm drop, and then stretch out long through that left arm. And then inhale, come back up. Exhale, go the other way, stretch long through that right arm. And back up. And then exhale, come all the way down in front. And so you kind of want to wiggle the hips back, walk the fingertips forward, let your head make its way toward the floor. A nice deep breath, and then roll it on up, and then again at the top, inhale, and then exhale, take a twist to the right, bring that right arm behind, left hand to the outside of that right leg, and just sort of rotate into that twist, looking over the right shoulder, bringing out the spine. Twists are a great morning pose. It kind of signals to your organs that start working after they've taken a rest overnight. Then inhale back up, and then exhale. Take it the other way for a couple breaths. Mm-hmm. take a hold. Another thing to really warm up in the morning is the hips. Hips tend to get be tight 24/7, especially first thing in the morning. So just taking it like a baby. If you're a little tighter, you might have foot and knee in the hand. If you're a little more open, you might be in the elbows. And just start a little bit of rocking, a little bit of circling. Good. All right. Take the other side. Don't be alarmed by any creaks and cracks that you hear. That's good. Set both feet down the floor with the knees bent. Bring the hands behind the knees and then just start to find your way back into your balance. Lift the legs up. If you're not feeling very balanced today, you can keep a big toe on the floor. And once you're here, relax those shoulders. Open the chest and then pull in through the core. Really getting our core fire working this morning. Getting ourselves ready to do some flow at the end of this class. If you feel like you can release those arms and challenge your core a little bit more, go for it. Big breath in and out. And with your next inhale, send the legs out and the arms up. And then exhale, forward fold, up over those legs. Don't force things, just kind of let yourself settle wherever your breath is taking you. Let the arms, shoulders, head and neck just relax. Don't worry if your body doesn't look like this in this pose. I teach a lot of classes every week, so get to wherever you're getting, and then slowly roll up. Good. All right, now we're going to come over onto all fours. So take a second and just get yourself set up with those hands underneath the shoulders, knees underneath the hips. And so another thing we want to focus on in the morning class is our spines. And so to start out, just getting some suppleness in the spine, we're going to start with an inhale. Let the belly drop with that back arch. Let your eyes reach up, and then exhale, pull that belly button and round the back, drop the head, again, inhale, and exhale. One more time each way. Really think about articulating through each and every vertebrae, using that full breath all the way to the upward look with the eyes, and then full breath all the way back. Good. All right. And then just bring it back to hands and knees. We're going to stretch our right leg back. And then bring it behind us. And now rotate. Lift that right arm up to the sky. Lift that right hip up to the sky. Open up. If you want a little bit more, you can let that right arm really drape back and let the chest open up to the sky. One full round of breath. And then slowly come back down. Good. Repeating that on the other side, stepping that left leg back and then behind us and bring it up. And again, play around with that arm position, how much openness and stretch that you'd like. Good. And then unwind it again. All right, back to all fours. We're going to tuck our toes. And when you're ready, press on up into down dog. So make sure those hands are planted very well. Get those hips up nice and high. Start to envision yourself like you're in an inverted V shape. And then those heels can be floating up off the mat as much as you need. Hamstrings, again, notoriously tight, especially in the mornings. So take a second and then just start a pedal. Let one heel at a time melt toward the floor. Take a second. If you're feeling tightness, sit with that tightness. Sit with that discomfort. Take a breath. Let things unfold. Good. All right. On your next inhale, come up high on the toes. And then as you exhale, let both heels melt to the mat. Good. All right. And then let's drop it down and sit it back in the child's pose for a couple breaths. Slowly lower ourselves down to our belly. So you can use the knees bend those elbows and see how slowly you can kind of control this lowering down. And then once you get there, release the tops of the feet. Keep those elbows bent in nice and tight. We're going to lift up into a cobra pose. So back bends are another important part of the morning practice because they start to get the blood moving, start to energize the body. So roll those shoulders away from the ears. Open up the chest. Relax through those butt muscles. Good. Let's all take a nice little look over that right shoulder. Back into child's pose for a breath. Good. All right, bring ourselves up. We're going to come all the way up to standing at the top of our mats. So make your way up. We're going to start in mountain pose. Before we go into a flow of sun salutations is a great way to start your day. Get the body moving, everything's warmed up. All of our muscles are involved, so it's a great series of poses. First thing I want you to do is imagine that you're nuzzling your foot and your feet down into the sand and kind of getting that solid footing. And then let those legs be nice and strong, shoulders roll back. Good. With your next inhale, we're going to send those arms out and up. And then exhale all the way forward, folding. Inhale, halfway lift and look out with either hands on the floor or maybe the shins, and then exhale, fold it back in toward the legs. Good, step it back to plank. And then on your next exhale, slowly lowering back down and coming up into your back bend. Cobra pose if you can get there, Sphinx pose if you want to take a milder version. And then send it back into down dog. A full round of breath, and then walk step, or maybe even take a little hop to bring those feet back up to the hands, into a halfway lift, exhale, fold, inhale, rise all the way up, exhale, hands to the heart. Good, once again, big inhale, fill those lungs, big exhale, empty out. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Really using that breath to ignite ourselves this morning. Step back to plank. And going through our flow, come on down and swooping up into that back bend. And send it back into down dog. I'm going to keep this a little shorter today, but you can add as many sun salutations as you'd like to. 10 is really a great number in the morning. Now we're just going to take a little step off the edges of our mat, find a good squat position for you. We all kind of know where we feel best. And then just take a big breath in. And as you exhale, coming down into our squat. Now, if you're pretty high in your squat for tightness reasons, bring those hands to the floor. You can maybe lower a little bit more. If you're feeling pretty good in this, you can bring those elbows to the inner knees, bring the hands together in that prayer posture. Take a couple breaths again, opening up the hips. Good. All right. Bring the hands to the floor if they're not already. And just start to bring yourself down to sitting. And then we're going to bring ourselves down onto our backs. So take a moment. You can roll up and down a couple times. Kind of a nice playful thing in the morning. But you don't have to. We're all just gonna meet down on our backs. Hug your arms around. Take a second. Exhale. Just feel the shoulder blades melt into the floor. Let your eyes close again. Take a nice little rock from side to side. Good. Stretch that left leg out long on the floor, right leg up to the sky. And just take a nice little stretch, keeping the shoulders relaxed.
the end, we're gonna let that right arm open out to the side, cross that knee over to the left. Let your head roll to the right if it wants to. Couple nice deep breaths. Good. Bring it back and we'll just switch it out, bringing that left leg up to the sky this time, and just grabbing, taking a nice stretch, relaxing, adding any movement through the foot. And then we'll bend that knee in, let that left arm open out, cross the knee over to the right, and just let your head roll to the side. Good, roll back, and just take a moment, stretch yourself out like it's the first stretch in bed in the morning. Find as much length as you can, like you're being pulled in opposite directions. And then, we're just gonna relax yourselves, let yourself completely let go and find a good place for everything to rest. Let your eyes close. Once again, think about softening anywhere that you find tightness. Let go, slow down the breathing. And just stay there. That's our Shavasana pose. It's the dessert of class. It's that quiet time at the very end that allows your body to absorb everything that we've done in the rest of class. And hopefully get you well on your way with a perfect start. Yoga is always a perfect start to any morning. So stay there as long as you need to and then jumpstart your day. I thank you very much for joining me.